Right. I said, does anyone know what is filibustering? Filibustering is a term which is used to denote useless talking. Okay? There is another term, stonewalling. Stonewalling means that you carry out useless activities to delay something. So what is stonewalling to activities? Filibustering is to talking. There is a celebrated episode of V.K. Krishna Menon, at that time our foreign minister, before you were born. He filibustered in the United Nations for 8.5 hours or something, finally collapsed at the end of it. All right? So I said, we'll filibuster till the others join. Right? So we can cover what we did last time. Does anyone remember what we covered last time? You may consult notes. What did we cover? Yes? No, you don't say, Viraj. Let him say. All right, your excuse then. Tell me, Viraj, what did we cover? What is leadership? What is leadership? That was first. All right, then?
Traits of being a leader.
Okay.
What will be the value system?
All right. Okay. Good. So, is that very clear? What is a leader and what is a manager? Did we talk of that too?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Yes, sir. All right.
Managers, administrators, leaders, you know.
Right.
A series of different.
Okay. But let me tell you, you see, people are not fully agreed because there's big overlap. There are a lot of leadership roles which managers will have to play during their careers. All right. And there's many managerial roles as defined in last time, which leaders also have to exhibit. You can't lead all the time, no? Sometimes you manage, sometimes you lead. So it is a mixture, an admixture of both. So in the end, what happens? In your functions and activities, there are certain roles which may be termed as leadership roles, which you play for some time. And there are certain roles which are managerial roles, okay? So this time, we are going to talk about roles. Leader stroke manager role. So we have tried to equate both now, saying they are not in distinct compartments. They are one and the same, but they wear different caps at different times. Okay? Now let's start by understanding what is your impression or understanding about what is the role of a leader. Role of leader. Tell me, Krishna, tell me, what is leader's role? Tell me one role. Please fill up the front, please fill up the front from that side. Inspire. What else?
Delegate,
that is give away the work, basically. Come to office. Call people and mark all the papers. Let me know. Is delegate a role of a leader? Delegation.
Proper delegation.
Proper.
Delegation.
Do you think that might be more a role of a manager? Maybe. I don't know. You know, there's no cut and dried. What do you feel about it?
I would rather say that. Meaninglessness in arguing the function of a manager and a leader.
Meaninglessness?
In the sense that leading is a, how do I say?
That's the point. It is very, very, shall we say, nebulous.
Leading is a behavioral trait. And managing is more in terms of an organization.
That's one view, so, Viraj. That's one view. You are saying leading is a behavioral trait. Now there are other thoughts also, there are other schools of thought. You know, when we come today, we'll cover. Yes, you're right, but not always. Sometimes it's performing functions. That is also part of leadership. It has nothing to do with traits. We'll come to that, okay? But that's a point to be noted. It's not only trait connected, it's not only connected with leadership trait. Also connected with activities and functions. And that is what we are saying. So delegate, I put a question mark, I put it here. Any other roles of a leader that you can think of? Development of subordinates. Like Gandhiji tried to develop Nehru ji and Sardar Patel ji, that kind of thing.
Mentoring,
developing. Mentoring. Anyone else wants to add anything?
Resolving conflicts.
Resolving conflicts. Conflict resolution. Resolution. I think so. But at the same time, it may also be a leadership role. Even leaders at helm of national affairs, they have to resolve conflicts, no? Like the Prime Minister has to resolve the Kaveri waters conflict. Okay? So it's both. We started this class by saying that there's a lot of overlap of roles of managers, and therefore we put a header saying leader stroke manager. Okay? Now, these are the various roles, and there are many others which you can list down. But there were some seminal studies done by Mintzberg, and he did it by direct observation. And from his observations, he brought out what he called our basic, very basic primary roles. And within this, there are some subsidiary roles. So the first, he says, is an interpersonal role. Interpersonal, that means dealing with people, communicating with people. Okay. And within that, he says, a subsidiary is a figurehead role, and that arises from position. Read this as authority. Authority position. For instance, I tell you that I have appointed you from, with effect from today, Polash, as the prefect or head or group leader of this class. So I am delegating or empowering you with some of my authority. So by that very act, all right, you acquire a position, and therefore connected with that position, there may be many duties which are ceremonial. Vinod Gupta comes, okay, so as a class rep, you go to the station to meet him, okay. So these are all ceremonial. Look at IIT director, look at the amount of ceremonial work he has got, my God, it's mind boggling. Every day or the other, there's some ceremonial work. You have so many short-term courses being run, each vies with the other to have the director come and inaugurate it. Okay? Now, so far we haven't done it. Maybe we should run a few short-term courses, call him to inaugurate. Then you have the Hijli school has the annual athletic meet, they'll call the director. You have the Republic Day, flag hoisting, director. So it's full of ceremonial. The moment he's not director, but he's promoted, let us say. All right, that ceremonial role goes. It is there everywhere. So this is one of the roles, leader role, motivation, subordinates, and accomplishing, all right, subordinate development, accomplishing organizational goals. This is well known. This is more like a manager's role. All right. What else? He also has a subsidiary role, which is a liaison role. Okay? And what is liaison? It is basically interacting external to his group or his unit or organization. What is the kind of liaison role which, let's say, IIT director has to play? What kind of role? Anyone, what kind of role does he play?
Interacting with government.
Yes, that's right. Interacting with government. Liaison role. So regulatory authorities, let us say. What else? industry. What else?
Other
IITs, research organizations,
other schools, other institutes,
maybe the community, right? People want IIT to adopt some village here or to give some medical facilities from IIT hospital. So the community. Yes. Other universities and so on. So broadly, according to Mintzberg's classification, you have the interpersonal role, and within that you have the liaison role, right? And you have the ceremonial role, and you have also your own leadership role, which is more a managerial role, all right? Motivating, developing subordinate, accomplishing organization goals, and so on. Next major classification is informational. Informational again has subdivisions: monitor, disseminate, and be the spokesperson. Monitoring is scanning environment and collecting information. Disseminating is sharing information. Spokesperson, sharing information with outsiders. That's the difference. Any question on this? How do you juggle so many roles? You only have about 24 hours. That is the art and science of management and leading. But in effect, it boils down to chasing crisis. So if you are in the middle management, if you are in very senior and top management, you try to avoid chasing crisis so that you have time for strategy, for long range thinking, for developing relationships with various constituencies who impact your organization and your desired outcome, that is your performance. Critically, that's what you should do. For instance, banks, if you are in a company, constantly you require to, as a top executive or the CEO, to have good relationship with banks, shareholder groups. Reliance, for instance, brought in a new term into the industrial or business environment in India. That term was investor relations department. Before that, all our companies used to call it shares department. That was generally understood. Reliance coined this terminology, investor relations department. So this term, relationship all the time, because Dhirubhai Ambani, if you remember, one of the unique things he gave to the environment, business environment, was the small investor. He became a god for the small investor. He helped them become rich, fulfill their dreams. So the holding of Reliance Industries is massive. Okay? You have 2 million shareholders in Reliance Industries, all holding small shares.
Largest.
So he said the relationship with the investor is very, very important and critical, and that he used to manage himself as a CEO. Okay? So spokesperson, sharing information with outsiders. It happens, no? Union Carbide has a massive gas leak, no? You remember? And it became a global tragedy. It was the biggest industrial disaster till then and even till now. In terms of human tragedy, death and recurring, people are still suffering from eye damage and so on. Okay. Well, you can say after Hiroshima and Nagasaki, all right, but that was not an industrial disaster accident. That was war. So in war, there are many wars where more people die, but not in industry. But when that happened, imagine someone had to be a spokesman, no, to the regulatory authorities and the community. And that is a role which the leader has to play. All right. Any questions?
The monitoring information, would it be
Monitoring information, scanning environment, collecting information. Yes, what is the question?
There shouldn't be more of assimilating information. Assimilating the information. Because
what is assimilating? Means
making sense of the world.
Making sense, analyzing. Well, it can be also, but is that the leader's role? Probably he'll give it to the bright young MBA, you know. He gets raw information and says, Francis, just analyze this and make some sense out of it. Give me a short executive summary. But scanning the environment, you know, scanning environment for what? Bengal Chamber holds a high power symposium. It's his job, the CEO, to go there just to mix around and see what is happening. Maybe he finds that there's a group from Japan which is showing interest in an area of business which is important to his company. He meets people. If anyone disagrees, please speak up. I think assimilating is not so much a role of the leader. Rohit, would you like to support your fellow intern? You're coming next door. Gathering the information, scanning. Any other questions? Why is this queued like this? There are only four people sitting this side, all the rest there. Am I missing some queue? Is there something underlying? Nothing at all? Just random?
Near the door.
You know, in Japan, what is the convention? Convention is the big boss, any room that he sits in, he sits farthest from the door. This is the convention. So if you have any collaboration with the Japanese, you know, and you're dealing with them, we used to have a little book which we used to read, published by Americans. Okay, customs and something of Japan, a little red book like this, where they used to tell you all this. When you get into a car, do's and don'ts. So that you don't hurt their sensibilities. So, I don't know, maybe they are the senior most here. Krishna certainly is. So, any other questions on this? Good. Next. Informational. And here you have four subdivisions: entrepreneurial, disturbance handler, resource allocator, and negotiator.
Last one was
informational. All right. So what should this be? Tell me. Read this and see. Come, this is a teaser. Implementer. Implementer, he says. Everyone agrees? Implementer. You have to do what? C? Executive? That's about the same. Yes. Entrepreneurial. Disturbance handler. Resource allocator. And negotiator. No, not institutional. I think this implementer, can you think of a better word? But a better word. What kind of role?
Executive.
Yeah, executive role, right. Managerial.
Initiative.
Traditional managerial role.
Initiative.
All right, you can say initiator, but isn't it traditional managerial? Disturbance handler solving crisis and disputes, allots resources. For the scarce resources in the company, there are so many people who want those resources, right? So allocation, these are all traditional managerial roles. Okay. and negotiating at all levels to do his department's work efficiently. This is a cue, a hint, his department. So it's a managerial kind of role. Any questions on that? Now you see how interesting this is. You have so many studies which are done, all right, and each of these studies they try to classify it in a little different kind of a way. You have PhD scholars, you know, who are working for the professors, so they have to publish the papers, so they try and do it a little different. But when you look at it from a helicopter view, it's about the same. Look at this. Other studies, more recent, right, which is about 15 years ago, it says yet again, doesn't say informational, doesn't say manager. What does it say? Interpersonal, it says, motivator, analyzer, and taskmaster. Okay. Do you see any difference from the original one? Very little difference, right? Interpersonal is same, interpersonal, right? No change. Motivator is also there as a subpart, all right? Now, informational, probably analyzer, we'll see that. Taskmaster, yes. So,
is it necessary for a leader to be a hard taskmaster or what?
Good question. Good question. Is it necessary for a leader to be a hard taskmaster? Come, someone tell me. Is it necessary for a leader to be a hard taskmaster?
Huh?
What is hard taskmaster? That means he demands that whatever task is set, well, firstly, he gives demanding tasks, okay? That means instead of 2 exams in the year, let's say we give you 6 exams, okay? Instead of earning how many, 88 credits or so for your MBM, we say you have to earn 200 credits within the same 2 years. That's giving hard tasks, you see, starts with that. And then having given the task, he insists on targets, which are tight targets. Like in America, you saw, they are very fanatical. Right or wrong, they are fanatical about meeting time targets. They are little different from us. Most of our projects, they go beyond time overruns, and consequently, there is cost overrun because time is money. But there, they are very, very careful, and in fact, they judge your performance quite a bit on the timeliness with which you do your work. Would you agree? Yeah. That's one of the hallmarks of a productive and society in the first world. It goes everywhere, runs like a thread throughout the society, including coming on time to parties, picnics, anywhere. Time is very, very important. So that is hard task. You set stretch tasks and then you insist and demand that you do them.
Rather than pushing, he motivates the other people to do it.
That's another way. He says that he motivates. That means he gives easy tasks, but he says, look, I know you can do better. You know, so I don't have to set it for you. You do it on your own. Motivation. Yes, motivation is also a powerful way of doing it. Yes, Rohit?
You can get quick wins out of that approach, but ultimately,
the subordinate will turn wiser and understand that.
You see, the different kinds of values and attitudes which are coming out. Each of you are going to is going to be a manager, right? Each of you is going to have different managerial style. You will play more or less same roles, am I right? You will go to corporations, roles are more or less same, but your styles will vary greatly. And we will cover that, what are the kind of styles you have, you know, all this has been researched. But what you are saying is very right, there are two types of styles. One is a task oriented style, the other is humanistic or people oriented style, is motivation. Okay, some managers, their style is people oriented. Now, which is better? This is the eternal debate. It has to be balanced. Everything in life has to be balanced, right? Why are you laughing? It's a verity, it has to be balanced. Then they come up with something called the situation, right? In different situations, you require a different kind of approach, is it not? Yes or no? So you have to have a skillful combination to be a successful leader and a manager. You have to skillfully combine the big stick with the carrot. Okay? Now, this study furthermore tells us that these roles were correlated with organizational performance. They went a step further and said each of these roles, is there a correlation with the performance of the organization? If you adopt these roles, and they say business performance and organizational effectiveness. We come back again and again to these two. The main concern of organizations is what? Performance or productivity or profit, and what else? Employee satisfaction, job satisfaction, all right? Now, here they looked at business performance and organizational effectiveness. They didn't look at the job satisfaction, but they looked at, these are two nuances. Business performance is termed as growth and innovation, that is a performance. Organizational effectiveness, this is measuring your short term objectives. In order to grow and then innovate, you have to survive in the short run. If you die, if you go bankrupt. So this remain, this is referring to the short range, this is the long range. And what are the findings? Those leaders who can play multiple competing roles produce the best performance. Versatility, multiple and competing, mind you, think about it. Can you give me an example? What is multiple and competing role? Multiple means many. And competing, I can understand multiple, but how about competing? Give me some examples. Anyone feeling sleepy will give the example, then this will wake up. It's like when you are driving on the highway, you feel sleepy, what do? You stop, you have a cup of coffee, and sometimes you splash some water. So, answering question. Because it's an afternoon session, fag end of the day, you're tired. So I have to perform multiple role. I have to wake you up also, and at the same time, instruct. Yes. What is competing? Competing roles. Those who get good performance, they play multiple and competing roles. Talks of versatility. Yes, the answer is to some extent yes. For instance, a competing role, you know, tell me, Pala.
Contradictory roles. I mean, in one situation, he has to be a taskmaster, for example. In another completely different situation, maybe he will have to adopt a human relations approach.
So would you agree to this?
That's not contradictory, sir.
Competing.
No, what is that?
No, not contradictory. What is contradictory? There are two different ways.
But that would be competing roles.
But is the role then different?
The competing role being,
what is competition? One against the other, right? Can we define competition? One against the other. That means not of the same, but different, opposing. Opposing. So if you debate this a little further and say, once you are a taskmaster, other time you are a motivator. Are these by any ways competing? Are they opposite?
No.
They are not opposite, they are about the same.
By
both
behavior,
are same.
By behaving like a taskmaster, you basically give her motivation to work, otherwise you get into trouble.
It's a little far fetched. I think it is competing, is it not? Because it's the opposite. Is absolutely 180 degrees apart. Now, not many of us can do this. It sounds easy, but we all have our styles. We think we are doing something this way, but we don't know. How you know? We get feedback. We may think we are very expansive. You know, we have great motivators, and we are human-oriented, people-oriented in our style. But sometimes you are in for a surprise if you get anonymous feedback. The feedback tells you no, that's your self-perception. Actually, you're quite dictatorial and authoritarian. So now, how many of you can play multiple competing roles? That's what you are preparing for. To give good performance, those who give good performance, hopefully, will get good promotions. They will be successful. No?
Sir, isn't it the competing roles that is it the leader as a subordinate, also a leader as a boss? Are these
that's interesting. That is interesting.
Well, take that question forward. Is it like being a leader and being part of the team at the same time?
Yeah,
he said it first. He gets the credit for that. He said it first. Krishna, it is interesting thought. What he is saying is competing level wise. First you are talking to your subordinate, all right? Then you are a boss. Then you are talking to your boss, you are a subordinate. And you have great skill in playing both these different roles. I won't call it competing yet. I said different roles.
Competing.
Competing within. So this is the value of debate. You see, so many aspects and facets come out.
These are not competing roles, conflicting.
You see, all competition, gentlemen, doesn't necessarily bring conflict. Would you agree? If you don't have dysfunctional kind of competition, all right? Like you have competition in the Spring Fest, does it give conflict? Usually not. But it may give conflict if it's not a fair competition, if the rules of the game are not followed. Okay? Right. Yes, tell me.
Competing should necessarily mean something is common there. Besides the fact that the same person is doing two different roles, it could also probably mean that two different roles require the same set of skills for him to apply. And which is why he's dividing time off.
Yeah, but what is he competing against or with? That's
so
the point.
The roles that
okay.
He's performed.
Give an example. You may be right, but try and give an example. Because all this, if you give an example, then you get clarity in the point that you are putting forward. Now that's the difficult part, to give an example. You may be right. All right. Let's go on to the next. So, now an even more recent study, you see how things move. You keep doing studies and then you review, you know, many of these research projects are nothing but a review of the earlier. And the premise there is that things are not stationary. Human systems, they keep changing on a time frame also. So many studies are repeated. This is more recent. And here, what does this show? Role of senior level executives. They have, this study has focused on senior level. That's what we are basically interested about. Right or wrong? None of us is interested in junior and middle level, right? We all are interested in senior level. Mobilizer, ambassador, driver, auditor, and servant. They're very catchy phrases. You know. When you publish a research paper, you must have something different. Catchy phrases. And how American this is. This, they have a nice gift for putting things very succinctly and with a lot of punch. Ambassador, driver, auditor, they are very graphic. Mobilizer is more conceptual, right? But ambassador, you know what is an ambassador? Not the car, but you know, a potentate who goes. Driver, you know, auditor, servant. Do you agree with this? That this is a role classification? Yes or no? You agree? Sure. finally, these words also, because the whole point is the spectrum is so large and you know the roles are so large that sometimes it becomes just semantics. Quite right. Okay. Now, we have talked of roles and we have talked of what leadership is. Emergence of a leader. How do leaders emerge? We have a term called emergent leadership. Leader is chosen by members of the group and a leader status is given to him. The leader style and interpersonal relationship with the members of the group plays a significant part in his being chosen. So some leaders emerge like this. Can you give an example? This one surely you will be able to give an example. See what? Emergent leader. No, that's a description. Give me an example.
Political leaders.
Hmm?
Political leaders.
Political leader, yes.
No,
Ashutosh says political leader.
No, sir.
No?
Sir, how many times legislation chooses a party leader? It's imposed.
Wait. Oh, just a moment. How many times? Legislator, I heard legislation. Okay. Legislators choose.
Ravi Devi as their chief minister. It's imposed by Lalu Yadav. It's not
leadership.
All right, this is a topical thing, but let's come to the essence.
So Mahatma Gandhi, for example, I mean, he was chosen by the people, he automatically emerged.
He started such a way.
You see, his example, we should not look at because he was more than a leader. Many hold him as a saint and a yogi and so on and so forth. But coming to the common garden, you see, examples like we mortals, the first thing when you joined here, what did we tell you? That we want some class reps, all right? And we want people to head certain activities, isn't it? Like the brochure committee, various committees. We didn't appoint, right? We didn't appoint anyone. We said, we want the names. And what happened in the what process happened? Do you remember? You had all joined, bright, young, eager, aspiring MBMs. And the first thing, you got a pep talk and say, all right, now most of our activities are student driven. Give me the names. Professor Roy must have told you. By today, taskmaster, this evening, give us the names. Who will be in what committee, leader? And what happened? You formed the group, or within your group, did you debate? I am curious to know. Tell me. Tell me.
It was widely debated with Naived taking the lead role in the debate. Is he here?
It was debated. Everyone was present and it was debated as a body, all right?
People of similar interest flock together to form.
Like vegetarians. Yeah. So then what happened? You came to a decision, an agreement. So the leader emerged, isn't it? Did everyone agree with the leader? No. Why not?
Sir, if everybody agrees to leaders, sir, they are not doing anything.
Not if. Why did they not agree, everyone?
Sir,
that comes to an important
depends
point.
Opinions,
hmm?
Depends of opinion from the leader. If the persons who are
all right
in the group, they
okay, have. But let me tell you.
Two different person has two different interests.
Okay.
So, it is not necessary that all the time my interest will match with the group's interest.
It won't. Surely it won't. I mean, it will be very unlikely.
Right.
Even if you are identical twins, the interests may not match. Huh.
That's why they are not agreeing to leader.
But here they agreed, but they agreed formally to accept him, but did not agree to the choice. Is that, that is my understanding. Or they walked out and say, we don't accept him at all. Was the acceptance there? All right. So what is emerging now from this discussion? What is emerging is when you have an emergent leader, all right, and when you have a leader who is, shall we say, appointed, the style becomes important, the leader's style. See, one great example you can give in organizational setting is the union leaders. Union leaders are not appointed leaders usually. They are emergent leaders, okay? Student leaders is another example. Now, in that kind of leadership emergence, it is usually found that the style of the leader is acceptable to the larger body of that constituency. And that style is acceptable because usually that leader exhibits good interpersonal skills. That means he can behave in a manner which suits different types of people. He can be a jolly good fellow with extroverts. When he is with introverts, he can be serious and discuss serious issues and topics. So everyone feels that he represents a part of him or her. That is important. Managerial style is important in the makings of an emergent leader. So if you are going to choose certain occupations where leadership is dependent on style, interpersonal skills, all right, then you will make a success if you have that. Otherwise, don't choose it. Yeah, share it with us. What is it? Tell me. Who was it? Acha. So that is my authoritarian style. I like to hear, you know, anyone who is talking in the class. On the other hand, an appointed leader, the style is not relevant. Is it really relevant? Someone is appointed by an authority who is legitimate authority. He appoints some leader. And those who are in the group, do they have any say in the matter? Let us say he is appointed because the boss likes him. Simply that. Does the, say I appoint you, your style is horrible, awful, your interpersonal style is no good, but I appoint you, I think the group has to accept you. Accept what? Accept your role as a leader, not you as a person. They will never accept you as a person if your style is not good, if your interpersonal skills are not good. But if you are appointed leader, as a leader in the role, they will accept you. And that in fact is a pity. What happens? particularly in management union relationships, you have, I think I mentioned it before in your class, my experience is leaders from the union side are usually better leaders than managers who lead from the management side, because of this same point. They are appointed, and when they are appointed, there are many factors which go into that appointment. See, they are appointed by human beings. These are subjective appointments. But in union case, this is due to some intrinsic qualities of the person. Interpersonal skills can be learned, but you have to learn it means you also inherit some of it intrinsically. In a personality, extravision, that is being extrovert, is something which is a personality trait or quality. So therefore, this is something which is intrinsic. Yes. Yeah.
Managers or leaders who are from the organization, they are limited to certain rules which they very strictly have to follow because they are the executives of the organization.
Right.
You see, the union part, though the rules and regulations are valid for them, there can be occasions where they may not follow those rules and regulations and go away with it. It is basically a scenario, for example, when Bombay police catches the underworld, the kind of killings the underworld does. The moment Bombay police reverts to that kind of killing, the underworld activities stop. But normally, when they are more within the rules and regulations, things go on. What I'm trying to say is basically people who are internal to the organization as individuals, whether the police or the managers inside the organization, they have to strictly follow the rules and regulations.
Why I'm not responding? Because I was only thinking that what we are discussing, when I say union, I mean union which is employees also of the company, not the outside leaders.
I was talking of employees definitely. But blue collar employees with.
But are they not subject to the same rules and regulations of the company?
They are. But suppose some blue collar employee union leader, taking the cases and Hindi movies into account, about, say, for example, the mills which have closed down in Bombay.
Right.
The kind of. If they come into a physical conflict, say a union leader or a big bunch of the workers' union, which the manager who is trying to control will not come into. Because he is totally bound by the rules and regulation, and whatever his reasons, practically not to control the situation.
My view, I don't quite agree with you, Gaurav, because my view is that both are bound by the same kind of rules and regulations. An employee who is a union leader, a manager who is an employee, they are both bound by the same rules. Basic rules are same.
So what
you cannot conflict with the organization, right?
So that, suppose you are the CEO, you are telling me this. As a manager, I will 100% abide by what you are saying because this is a structure and rule. But say Atmaram, who is not executive form, the executive portion of the organization, is a blue collar, very much an employee. There might be a situation where his tolerance level may be on the check. So he may go overboard. And he may forget about the rules and
rules. No, are you saying that how does a union leader control his constituency? Is that what you are saying?
I'm saying that being an executive in an organization.
Yes.
Means I have gone through a certain education system.
Okay.
Which, when some organization says that this is your limit, I really understand that's my limit. But Atmaram has not gone through that education system.
No, you are raising a larger issue now.
And
what is right and what is wrong, you don't require education to know that. You explain.
Degrees of freedom.
Degrees of freedom.
The union representative, the degrees of freedom are generally higher.
I don't agree. I don't see
how. No,
I am making a premise here. These are not outside politicians who are presidents of the union. They are your own employees. If they are your own employees, they are subject to the same rules, limitations, as well as license as the manager.
Yeah, but then they are
the only. Haan ji.
They are backed by some external organizations which are more powerful than the organization itself. And what you do?
That's different.
So
that is different. That is not germane to this discussion. I am saying if you exclude that for the time being, for the purpose of our discussion, then the role of the union leader is more difficult, because he doesn't have the authority of the management, right? He has been elected, right, spontaneously. So he sometimes has to use other forms of authority, as you are saying.